I'm on site helping out one of my mates, and he wants me just to go round and change some light switches and some socket outlets. He's an electrician at the moment, changing the consuming. This installation has had an electrical installation condition report and will be fully tested after the consumer unit has been changed. Gives us a golden opportunity to look at pre-2004 cable colour. So we're going to look at some light switches, some lights and some socket outlets and discuss those changes that have occurred, maybe some good practices when swapping over electrical accessories for new fresh ones. Okay, so I'm going to replace this switch. Isolation procedure is fully in place. The board's being changed. I will prove it's dead before I do change it, but obviously it's hanging off of the wall. Let's have a look what we've got here. So we've got old cable colours. These are pre-2004. We're used to in the workshop seeing brown, black, grey. And in the old system, it was red, yellow, and blue. So to identify something as a switching line conductor, you can see small red sleeving on these. We've had discussions on the channel before about what colour to use as common. They've used yellow here. It'd be interesting to see other switches, whether they've continued that practice on or they've swapped it around as we go about. So this is going to get replaced. Let's have a look at the CPC. CPC secured in the back of the box. This could be changed in the future for a metallic one, so obviously we'll need to earth the exposed conductive part that a metal light switch would be. We've discussed that on the channel loads of time. I probably would have took it off the outer grey mechanical protection a little bit further back, but there is a grommet up here. So we have got a grommet, so that's good. So I'm going to change this. I'll have a look at the ends and see if they need to be remade, but it's not that long, so we'll see how damaged they are from being screwed in, whether they can deal with being screwed into again with a new accessory. So two-way switches off, and now I'm looking at the actual conductors. I'm looking for length first. They're not the longest, okay, but I'm looking at the copper to see how dented it is and what position. Now, if it was really low down and pretty well dented, I'd probably look to maybe replace it. I've got to work out whether the screw termination in there, if I screw into the same area again, could potentially break. 99% of the time, I prefer to strip them back and re-terminate them. It just comes down to length themselves. So I have to look at that area, make a judgment call whether I believe it could be screwed into again. I usually say no. I usually just strip back and re-terminate. Also, look at that one there. It's covered in nice bits of blobs of paint. That's not a very good electrical connection, so that will need to be cleaned up even if you were going to use that termination again. But I'm going to lightly just going to re-terminate all of those and then just put my new switch on. I will also confirm the CPC in the back box. So if we just look there, I'll just confirm that that CPC is also actually screwed into the copper. Okay, that we've got a good electrical connection up there. So I'm just going to replace this for a new two-way switch now. So I'm just going to straighten them out. It might give me a little bit more copper to play with. It's that bent area that I'm more concerned about. So if I just strip it back, I'm going to try these out as well. My wire strippers. Okay, look how easy that was, folks. All those people, Gaz is using a knife. And then obviously I'm just going to double those back over for all my terminations. So what I've got now is a nice, fresh, non-squeezed-in connection in order that my screw can penetrate to nice, fresh copper. And it's still of a reasonable length in order to do that. So I'll just do the rest and I'll connect it up. Just carry on as I go. Pliers, shows you how long it is. These are stiff as anything. I need to oil those up. I don't use them hardly anymore. So take me stripping tool, do like that. Makes life a lot easier in order that we can just double them over. We go again. Leave that. Fold those out of the way. I don't want to keep picking at the red sleeving. Hopefully it wouldn't come off the end. That one can be just straightened out a little bit. Just trim it back. And we go again. Now you've got to remember what colour we had as common. Otherwise you're gonna have a problem at the other end. And this one used yellow. Yellow is common. Through we go. So I made a connection there, ready to go. Like I said, I'm going to need to check that CPC is actually connected properly. So I'm just going to, confirm it was in the copper itself and not in the actual sleeve in itself. So that's nice and firmly in there, a lot tighter now. Might want to clean these out as well. I'll have to have a look. I've got a 3.5 re-threading tool. Might have to clean these out, but they look pretty good on this one. Some of the other ones might need doing it. So I can just now fit my new two-way switch using yellow as common. Remember, it doesn't matter which one is L1 and L2, so I wasn't worried about that. It was just what color was common. And in this case, yellow. I don't want to drop them out, so just be careful. The same as at college, isn't it? We undo the screws too far sometimes. We drop them on the floor and then we're searching for them. Okay, at college, you might be able to go and get another one out of the stores, but in here, if it falls through the cracks in the floorboard, I've lost a switch. Okay, so I've opened those up. Does it matter which way around it goes? No, because it's a two-way switch. So it doesn't matter which way around I go. So in other words, when I screw it back, I haven't got to make sure that what I'm thinking is down is on, because obviously it's two-wayed. You see how we're a little bit on the limit for length. I would have liked them a fraction longer. Get them nice and tight. Again, someone will say, why is there not torque settings for these type of screws? That's a good point. Why are they not Wago or Idle Industries style connections in the back as well? So I've got it on, made my connections, common L1, L2. Still got my identifying sleeving, in this case being red. I'll push it back into position, pull it forward, and then I just recheck them, because obviously they've moved around slightly. Just want to make sure, especially in sockets, I always find in sockets you normally get another half a turn. On the screw head on this one. Yep, confirm the CPC, we've got a grommet in. Okay, cable length's still okay. So they can be pushed back into position. Need to make sure that the conductors themselves don't come underneath the areas which the screws are gonna go into, the two tabs, because obviously you could screw straight back into the cables themselves, directly a fault to earth them. You would pick it up on testing, but obviously you don't want to damage the cable. So when you're pushing it back in, have a little look to see where they're going. First one finished. So here we've got a one gang switch, and then we turn it over, it's got common L1 and L2, and that's being used as a one-way switch. So it's common practice on site not to use one-way switches like we do at college, but actually use a one gang two-way switch, but use it as a one-way. So we look here, we've got the red common, we've got black, which is a switching line identified with red sleeving. It's gone in L2, and we've got our CPC secured to the back box. If you happen to put it on and down is off and up is on, it's just a simple case of just turning it round, okay, so you get it thrown the right way. So this one gang two-way switch is being used as a one-way switch in this system. I'm gonna change this one next. Okay, so let's have a look in a ceiling rose. So again, we're used now to seeing the colors being the old colors, so red and black replacing our new ones, which are brown and blue. Fantastic, the switching line conductor, which is black. So down to the switch, they've taken a red and a black, but the black isn't being used as a neutral. It's being used as a switching line conductor and is identified like so, and is in this block of two here. We've got the center loop section here where there's actually four red conductors in there. So obviously they've taken an extra one off, maybe a loft light, and that means we've got three neutrals in here as well and our CPCs. So the looping terminal here has our permanent line connection, our neutral connections over here, and our switching line conductor, which is a black cable with red sleeving in order to identify as a switching line conductor in the CPC. So that's what we've got going on in the ceiling rows. And again, we're used to seeing brown, blue in ours in a modern installation. So this is pre-2004. So now we've got a two gang switch. So two gang meaning we've got two switches on the front. So when we flip this one over, aha, so one of the sides of the switches is being used as part of a two-way system. So that yellow there, again, has been used as common, L1 and L2. If we just look on the other side, we're actually just using the other switch. So this switch here has just been used as a simple one-way. So in this case, they've used common and L2 in order to make that a one-way switch. So we've used a two-gang light switch. One of the switch sides being used as part of a two-way system, and one is simply being used as a one-way switch. You did notice maybe in the shot there, the CPCs were not connected to anything, just twisted together. So they're both in one piece of sleeving. So I will separate them when I remake it off. And obviously I'll re-terminate it wherever the earth screw is in here. We have got a grommet. Again, you can see, look, we've got the ability just to pull that cable backwards and forwards. So again, good use of a grommet there. Otherwise there could be some potential wearing against the box itself, which wasn't even earthed. And we can also see, look, we've got our red sleeving on, our blue, our yellow and our black, black one being again a switching line of part of the one-way circuit, and then our three core conductors as part of the two-way element. And like we said, yellow is common. So I'll have a tidy up of that, see what we can make that look like. So let's have a look at a socket outlet. I think the property had some surface sockets, and what's happened is all the walls have been replastered, so someone's chased back in the boxes. There is grommets in here, which is great. So obviously the outside mechanical protection is going to need to be stripped back a little bit further. And there we have our colours. The black is the neutral in this system. The red is the line conductor, and we have got green and yellow sleeving. I think the property was rewired around about the year 2000. Obviously, a lot earlier than that, PVCs, early PVCs used to have green sleeving only on the CPC. So this one has got green and yellow, and it's in good condition. Okay, it looks messy too because of paint and all stuff on it. Obviously, once I start stripping it back, it'll be perfectly good to be used again. And like I said, just probably earth the back box as well. I'm going to earth that and maybe lose these either down or strip them further back in order that I can make off this socket outlet. So just to confirm that this is isolated, I know it is, the board's actually off and he's connected some conductors together downstairs. So this will be interesting. So we're going to use our proving unit and our voltage indicator as we've been trained on. We need to check our test equipment works first of all. So yep, we're happy with that. So we've proved our instrument. We're going to probe on. We're going on the least dangerous conductor first. So in this case, CPC and line, nothing off the line. So I might as well do the neutral next, onto the neutral, off the neutral. And now we're going to do between neutral and line. This will be interesting. It's got a continuity, but no voltage. Okay, so there's no voltage there at all. So somewhere down in the board, they've actually joined these together. Perhaps when he was confirmed it was a ring, figure of eight testing, that actually we've got these two linked together. Okay, so no panic, there's no voltage there. Again, I could show you the consumer unit end, but we've done that in previous videos. So I'm just going to strip this back, take off the outer PVC, tidy this up and reconnect it, as well as earth the back box next. But before I do so, I need to prove my instrument is correctly working. So probing, as I did before, and you can see, obviously, that we're all good to go. So proved our voltage indicator, ready to go. So that is dead, okay, that is isolated, boards hanging off, etc. Next, I'm going to try my twin and earth strippers to see if I can get further down in here. Yeah, obviously on college I use a lot of time, I use my knife, etc. But let's see if this bit of kit will do it for us. So I'm just going to feed them into the body, down like so. You see they come through the handle and we get it down as far as you can. Now the problem is you can never really get as far into it as you would like. So let's see how far we can get it in. Give it a pull. See if this one comes off. See, that's a little bit tight. It didn't quite bite through, so again, that's going to make it a little bit more tricky. Maybe it's the time for the knife. Can I pull it off? Just see if I can just nick the corner there. Okay, so that's really stiff. Just that CPC sleeving off. Little trick there is always cut the end off. You'll end up catching your finger on that. So that comes that way. Pull them together. See if that'll slide off. Yeah, we'll go, but that was quite stiff. So you've got to now work out whether that is fur enough down for you to feel comfortable. Okay, I'll try the other one, see if I can get it a little bit closer. But yeah, that was a little bit easier, maybe not. We'll try the other one, see if practice helps. But I'm a little bit over there on the length. Okay, so there we go. And what I did find there, this, look how much it's pulled back up a little bit. So is there a chance of getting that to go down a little bit? Okay, like so. It's up to you whether you want to use them. It can be a saver, maybe for downlights, a little bit more tricky for sockets because obviously the amount of PVC just there. So I can, cables are stripped back and ready to be shortened and doubled over to terminate into the socket. There's no fly lead to this back metal back box of screws up here. We have got a movable lug this side, so this one moves up and down, and a fixed lug this side. So it's a case of not necessarily having to earth this back box. It's just best practice for me, so I will do. I haven't got any separate green and yellow singles that we'd use in conduit. So I've taken a piece of 2.5 copper. I'm gonna put green and yellow sleeving over it and we'll double it back and bring it forward in order that we can bring the CPC back to this metal back box. No fly lead to this back metal back box of screws up here. I haven't got any separate green and yellow singles that we'd use in conduit. So I've taken a piece of 2.5 copper. I'm gonna put green and yellow sleeving over it and we'll double it back and bring it forward in order that we can bring the CPC back to this metal back box. So earth the back box, nice and tight. Check it is tight. Okay, and then we're ready to connect the socket up. So I've got my socket outlet I'm gonna choose, and this one has two earth terminals within it where the CPC will be connected, either end and a bar between them, so linking them together. So what I'm gonna do is take one of the CPCs from the ring final circuit and put it in, say, the left-hand side, one of the CPCs and put it in the right-hand side, and I can choose which one has the fly lead. So I'm going to separate my two CPCs across the two earth terminals provided. And we'll go into more detail in the classroom why that's really good practice. So I'm going to work out the depth of my doubling over. Remember, for socket outlets, it's a deeper terminal than a light switch, so it needs to be a lot bigger. So I'm going to drop it in there like so, just so I can see the sort of depth that I'm going to have to do for doubling over. So it's probably going to be quite a good length. in order that I can fill that hole with our conductors. So double them over. Okay, I'll go around, double the rest of them over before obviously making those connections. So I've connected the socket outlet. Worth doing a visual inspection first. So L there with the two reds, N there with the two neutrals, so visual polarity check. One of the CPCs for the ring final circuit this side, one that side, as well as the fly lead going back to the box. I'll push it back into position and I'll recheck the screws are tight. So I've pushed it back into position and pulled it back out again, making sure no cables come behind the screwed positions here and here. And then I need to just check tighten them. Another little top tip, make sure you've got the right size head on your screwdriver to match the screws. Often at college, we use a terminal screwdriver for all of those early lighting circuits, and that's not acceptable here. It's too small. So make sure, we'll call it a medium flat tip at college, that we're using the right size screwdriver that matches the size of the head of the screw. So I'm going to recheck tighten these now, then it can be put back against the wall. So I said earlier about the possibility of getting lots of what they call snot, you know, plaster and cement in here, in order that you make a bad thread then and you struggle to get it in. So you can clean it out and then tap it out if you want. So you can take your tap and then just wind it in there. So this is a 3.5 mil tap. So I tend to go way further than I need to. And then back again, and that's created a cleaner thread for us in order to get our 3.5 machine screws in, yeah, using this tap. So obviously they've had electrical installation condition report, they're changing the board, obviously it's going to be tested fully afterwards. It's worth making a note, obviously, to the electrician going to test it, that this is on its own. So it could be one of two things here. It obviously could be spurred from the ring final circuit, or it could be they've converted some of the old storage heater points, which would be single 2.5s in most cases, going to a single box. It could be that they've chased a twin socket box in here, and actually this will be an individual radial effectively from the consumer unit. So worth making a note of that, just so people don't think it's either a spur or it's a converted point. It'll just make it a little bit easier on the testing process. I'm gonna try these again. Okay, so I'm gonna snip off my CPC end first. Like so. Let's see if I can get in and down in order to remove the outer mechanical protection. So I'm going to feed these into the actual tool again, get nice and straight before I start. So feed those through into here. Let's wind it down a little bit further. You can see the problem being that's as in the camera in. It's as far as I can get in before obviously making my cutting motion. Like so. Okay, then you've got to just see whether you've got all the way in there. Let's pull that off. Okay, so that will come back. I'll have to just check. Yeah, I thought I saw something, but no, it was obviously a bit of white paint or something like that on it. But yeah, that's clean, tidy, probably a little bit of a wiggle. Yeah, I'm happy now just to terminate this one, which is either spurred from the ring final circuit or an individual point that used to be a storage heater circuit. I must admit, something quite satisfying about doing this. In we go. I do like that. So as we look at this one, we can see that we've got a combination of pre-2004 and post-2004 cable colours. So it's either a radial circuit that was original and extended, or an alteration to a ring final circuit that we've got going on here. So we've got the new cable colours and the old cable colours, and we're going to go red and brown together in the back of the socket, blue and black together for the neutrals in the back of the socket, and obviously split the CPCs, and of course we're going to have to earth the back box as we've done in the previous ones as well. Okay, so you can see it here connected up. So two line conductors, brown and red together, two neutral conductors, black and blue together, the ring final circuit CPC split across the two earthing terminals, and the fly lead going back to earth the metal back box, grommets are in place, etc. So this one can go back on as well. So the electrician's finished off the consumer unit, he's started putting the stickers on, etc. Plaster is in there already covering it in muck. And I'm going around just to finish off the rest of the rooms to help them out. Obviously, full certification afterwards and a board change, so obviously all the circuits will be tested. It was a good chance for me to show you pre-2004 cable colours and just walk you through those slightly. We also use that 3.5 mil tap. We use those twin and earth strippers to see if they were any good. And obviously we talked about the need maybe to re-terminate cables when you're replacing electrical accessories, because it just damages the actual conductors themselves a little bit. So, as always, I hope this vlogging video has been some help.